Bless this day, Lord God, to do your will. Such a loving God, merciful God. We ask all in Jesus' name this day we pray.
church. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Deacon Smith. Beautiful selection of truth. He has the whole world in his hands. God, we thank for another Lord's Day. So we gather once again to lift the name of Jesus. We are grateful for the privilege of coming into his presence one more time. I want to remind the Mountain family, be in prayer for all of our sick and shut-in members. We want to be in prayer for the Jackson family and the loss of the late Deacon Billy Jackson Sr. I just learned this morning that there will be no funeral here at the church. We will have a wake Friday, on 4-7, the graveside service will be held on Saturday at 12 o'clock. And so we want to remember the family in our prayers. At this time, I want to also say that we're grateful for those who are those members, and most of you have just done wonderfully well in terms of contributing through tithes, offering, Sunday school missions, the building fund, etc. And do know that we are grateful for your gifts, and we encourage you to do that which the Lord has placed on your heart. The Lord loves a cheerful giver. And so we thank God that we can give not grudgingly, but we can give cheerfully.
Amen.
And God blesses us accordingly.
Yes. Amen.
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 We're going to move forward now with a selection from Sister Vanita White. chapter 8. In Luke's Gospel, chapter 8, the words of the text taken in verse 22 through 25. Now it came to pass on a certain day that he went into a ship with his disciples, and he said unto them, let us go unto the other side of the lake. And they lounged forth. But as they sailed, he fell asleep, and there came down a storm of wind on the lake. And they were filled with water and were in jeopardy. They came to him and said, where is your master? Master, we perish. And he arose and rebuked the wind and the raging of the water, and they ceased, and there was a calm. And he said unto them, where is your faith? They being afraid, wondered, saying one to another, what manner of man is this? For he commandeth even the winds and the water, and they obey him. Say once again that God is good to all of us.
Amen.
And we must never take him for granted.
Amen.
I want to just share with you for a few moments on the words of the text out of Luke's Gospel, chapter 8, verses 22 through 25. This is a story that all of us, I'm sure, are quite familiar. Jesus is with his disciples. They are in a boat, and Jesus says, let us go to the other side of the lake, and they launched forth. And while they launched, while they were sick, while they were enjoying a smooth, song of the wind arose on the lake. And when the song rose, it rose with such fury that the boat was filled with water. And the disciples, just by nature, knew nothing else to do, apparently, but rush to where Jesus was comfortably situated. In fact, Jesus was asleep, probably getting a little rest. Mm-hmm. And they arouse him to the point where they awake him. And they cry out, "Master, Master, we perish." And then Jesus arose, got up, and walked out onto the boat and simply rebuked the wind.
Yes.
Just simply speaking.
Yes.
He didn't have to call the five people out on the water to help them in that situation. He just got up and walked out and rebuked the wind.
Oh, yes.
He had that kind of power.
Well,
man.
He just simply said, "Peace."
Peace.
Be still.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
And the turbulent wind behaved himself.
Yes. Okay.
And got real quiet.
Yes.
Because they knew that this was not just one of the disciples talking.
All right.
And the wind knew that they had the disciples where they wanted
them. All right.
But when they heard a voice,
yes.
None other than the voice of Jesus.
Jesus, yes.
They got quiet.
Well,
amen.
And tucked themselves into the oceanic depths.
Mm.
And so, Jesus revealed to them something that perhaps they did not know he was capable of. I guess, in a word, they may have called themselves warning Jesus about a perilous situation.
Mm-hmm.
But no, Jesus didn't have to be warned. He's aware of all things.
Amen.
And Jesus just simply decided, since you all are so frightened, I'm going to calm your nerves.
Amen.
And I'm going to speak and tell the wind to be still.
Amen.
And there was a calm. But then he said to me, and this is a crucial question. He turns to the disciples and says, where is your faith? And they, being afraid, one of them saying one to another, what manner of man is this? For he commanded even the winds and water, and they obeyed him. And they arrived at the country of the Gadarenes, which is over against Galilee.
Amen.
What manner of man is this? My brothers and my sisters, the manner of man that Jesus is, is not just in man.
Well,
he is a man who created the heavens and the earth.
Amen.
He's the one who can hold the wind in the arc of his arm. He's the one that controls all of the elements of the sky.
Yes.
Who is this?
Who is
he? He's Jesus.
Yeah.
He is God's Son.
Yes.
He is the one who can do more by just speaking than we can do by not only speaking, but walking, talking, whatever. He's able.
Amen.
For he has not just some power, but he has all power.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. All power.
And the kind of power he has,
uh-huh,
is a power that cannot totally even be explained.
Amen.
Our challenge is not to try to understand all that Jesus is, because no matter how much we study, no matter how much we research him, no matter how long we walk with him, there are some things that we will never know concerning him. And the reason for that is some of us will get big, and we would think we were on par with Jesus.
Amen.
But Jesus has no equals. And so when he raised the question, where is your faith? It was obvious to Jesus that their faith was put on hold. Their faith did not show up. They talked about faith, they had preached about faith, but they didn't exercise faith. And sometimes, my brothers and sisters, we can talk a good talk.
Well.
But when it comes time to put that which we have learned, which we have embraced, as part of the principles and teachings of Christ, many times we do not put them in So Jesus puts the disciples on Front Street, if you will, and says to them, where is your faith?
Amen, amen.
Faith ought to take you somewhere. Faith should have stepped forth and said to them, if nothing else, we've got somebody else on the board.
Amen.
And as long as I've got King Jesus,
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We're going to be all right.
Yes.
Yes, we are.
We are all together.
Oh, yes.
We are still on the boat.
Yes.
We have not drowned. Mm. The boat may be filling up with water.
Well.
But we are all still here.
Yes.
And that's how faith talks.
Faith.
Faith has a way of seeing beyond the present.
Yes, sir.
And saying, I don't know how we're going to make it, but there's one thing for sure, as long as I've got Jesus.
Yes.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Tell it.
I can make it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
As long as I have Christ.
Yes, sir.
In my life.
Well.
And as long as I see him.
Yes.
As my help in a time of trouble.
Yeah.
I know I'll be all right.
Yes, sir.
Shame on the disciples. They missed a great opportunity.
Yes.
To exercise what Jesus figured to be faith. And he was saying, in effect, you got faith. Why don't you exercise?
Yes.
Or why didn't you exercise?
Well, well.
God is able.
Yes, sir.
To help us to see things.
Yes.
And to exercise that which has been planted in us. And when you have faith, even as small as a mustard seed,
well,
that faith will take you a long way. And so, my brothers and my sisters, I want to say to you today, this virus that is going around all over the world,
well,
it's really affecting many families.
Yes.
It's affecting many nations.
Yes, sir.
Many states.
Yes.
Many cities.
Mm.
But we need not act as though Jesus is not present.
Yes, yes.
Jesus.
Yes, he is.
Is still on the throne.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Jesus is still.
Yes.
Our companion.
Yes.
Jesus. Will help us.
Yes.
To get through the pandemic.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Jesus. Just calls us.
Yes.
And he wants us.
Yes.
To exercise a little more faith.
Yes. Yes.
Have faith.
Faith.
To believe that one of these old men,
well,
we don't know when, but he knows when.
Yes, he does.
It soon shall pass.
Yes, yes.
But God is able.
Yes, he is.
To hold us,
yes,
to keep us.
Yes.
But we gotta have faith.
Faith. Yes.
And you gotta act like you got some sense too.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Don't just assume,
yeah,
that because you have a relationship with Christ,
uh-huh,
that you can't contract the virus.
Well,
the virus is no respecter.
No, Yes, sir.
All persons.
No.
We got warning signs everywhere about wearing the masks and social distancing.
Mm-hmm.
We got all of these guidelines in place.
Yes.
But unless you observe, unless you follow the rules, you are subject.
Yes, sir.
And don't put that on Jesus.
Jesus
says you need to exercise.
Yes.
Your faith.
Yes.
And allow your faith.
Yeah.
To hold you in the hollow of my hand.
Yes.
God is so good today.
Yes, sir.
And I'm convinced that when I do my best, and when I act responsibly, and when I have the privilege to share my faith,
yes,
I need to tell somebody,
tell it,
that
Jesus
is the light,
come on now,
of the world.
Yes.
That Jesus is the bright and morning star.
Yes.
That Jesus is my lily of the valley.
Yes, sir.
He's everything.
Everything.
Do I have a witness?
Yes, sir.
He's my rock.
Yes.
In a weary day.
Yes, sir.
He's my shelter.
Yes.
In the time of sorrow.
Yes, sir.
I'm glad.
So glad.
That I know this man.
Yes.
I know him.
Yes.
To be a friend.
Yes.
In a time of difficulty.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
I know him.
Yes.
To be my prop.
Yes.
On every leading side.
Yes, yes.
I know him.
I know him.
To be a healer.
Yes, sir.
Of the sick.
Yes.
I know him.
Yes.
To do good things.
Yes, sir.
He's able.
Yes.
I said he's able.
Yes, he
is. Is he able?
Yes.
I know he's able.
Yes, he
is.
Thank God. That we have the privilege.
Yes.
Of exercise.
Yes, Lord.
Our faith.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Our faith.
Yes.
Not so much in us.
Come on.
Not in the government.
No.
Not in ourselves.
No.
But our faith.
Yes.
Is in God.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
yes,
it is.
I said that's where it ought to be.
Yes. Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God.
And he is yet faithful to us.
Yes.
Doors of the church.
Amen.
It may be somebody here. Somebody who needs this truth. I'm glad.
Let us all say,